Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This video is for those of you who are using Photoshop CC. I'm going to show you a couple of great new tools that Adobe added in the Camera Raw filter. Before we begin, convert your photo for smart filters. This will make any changes to the photo non-destructive. If you see this message, click OK or press Enter or Return. Then go back to Filter and click Camera Raw Filter. Click the Lens Correction icon, and under the Manual tab, we'll see the Upright feature. You'll see five icons under Upright. The first one is to disable Upright. So, if you decide you want to start over, click this icon. The big A is Automatic. This will automatically try to correct its perspective using a balanced set of perspective corrections. I'll click Disable. The Level Correction mode ensures that the image is level. The Vertical mode applies level and vertical perspective corrections. However, as you can see in this photo, it's not always that accurate. The Full mode applies level, vertical, and horizontal perspective corrections. You can also manually adjust the perspective. The sides look a little bowed out, so I'll go into distortion to correct it. If you slide it to the left, it bows it out, making the image convex. Sliding it to the right makes it concave. For this image, I'll slide it to plus 15. Sliding the vertical to the left or right adjusts its vertical perspective, while the horizontal mode adjusts its horizontal perspective. Rotate rotates the image on its center axis point. The scale reduces or enlarges it, and aspect stretches or squeezes it. Once you're happy with your image, click OK. To get rid of the empty areas, you could use Content Aware Fill or crop them out. For this example, I'll crop the image. First, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Then, make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangular selection across your image, cropping out empty areas. Go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. If you have a photo that has a lot of contrast and want to brighten just a few specific areas of it, convert it for smart filters, open the Camera Raw filter, and click the Radial filter. This will open the panel on the right. This filter allows you to make a lot of individual adjustments to specific areas of your image. Notice in this example, the exposure is plus 1.60 and the contrast is plus 15. If I drag the filter over a dark area, it immediately brightens to that exposure and contrast. You can adjust the filter's shape simply by dragging points in or out. You can also drag the filter to any location on your image. If you want to increase or decrease its brightness, simply drag the exposure to the right or left. You can also adjust multiple areas of your image and even overlap areas you already adjusted. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the power of the radial filter. The last new feature in Photoshop CC Camera Raw filter is the updated Spot Removal tool. Now, for the first time, you can remove long, irregular shapes more precisely than in earlier versions. I generally leave it on the heel mode because it blends in color and tone from the surrounding area. You can adjust the tool's size, feather radius, and opacity using these sliders. You can also adjust the size by pressing the left or right bracket keys on your keyboard. The black circle outline is the size of the tool, and the blue and white dashed circle is the feathering. When you draw over the object you want to remove, it creates two shapes. The red and white dashed outline is the target, which is the area you're healing, and the green and white dashed outline is the source, which is the area it's healing from. If you don't like the source area, drag it to other areas on your image until you're happy with the result. To remove other parts of your image, repeat the same steps. When you're done, click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.